Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today to welcome you back to Tropico 5 here at The Rock, where we are working on getting revolutionized. We're going to try to rebel against the crown, thereby winning the mission, declaring independence, ultimate goal here. I gotta show you some updates that I've made to The Rock since you last saw us. First of all, look at this fancy smancy mansion that we've got here. Who is living in this place? I couldn't click on him in time, but that's okay. We can see the residence. Cruz Ortiz. All right, so we got a whole family living in here. Four families, to be exact. And I don't know how they share all those rooms, but that's okay. Disaster! The revolutionaries are demanding that you insult the king. All right, this is risky business. We can refuse them, and they will riot, which does not help us at all. Or we can have unknown consequences by insulting the king. We've been souping up our defenses. The towers have been created, so I'm welcoming any opposition they will bring. It appears that what we will end up doing is sending the king an insulting gift. So we can send him a piss pot, a bent sword, pink undergarments. I like pink undergarments. We will send those to him. Scandalous. The queen is furious that you presented her husband better undergarments than the ones he bought for her recent birthday. As a result, the king was forced to punish you. What are my punishments? Apparently, it was too harsh even for words, but the total effect after it was softened by Lord Oakesworth. His building costs are increased by 20% for 2 years, so he's just going to make me pay a bit more money. That's fine. Other additions to The Rock include a number of homes. So we got four houses right here, now growing their own food in the back of the country house. And of course, we can take a look at these guard towers in all of their completed glory. In fact, there should be some soldiers patrolling the streets somewhere. Is this one of them? I think so. Oh, I like that you can see a whole family tree up here. That's just really nifty. Lots of money coming in with $7,000 from the freighter. And the mine, of course, is really helping us out on that front. I queued that up at the end of the last video. It is now complete with a road connecting to it. And that's going to be producing quite a bit of money for us to boot. Guys, I think we're about to experience our first disaster. There is an earthquake on the island. It's shaking everything. We're gonna zoom out so we can oh no, the homes, not the country houses that I just made. Oh, these are being destroyed down here too. Oh dear. Wow, this is not a small earthquake at all, is it? It's destroying so much stuff. We lost five country houses and a plantation, and the international community has sent us $14,700 as disaster relief. I didn't know during the colonial era that the international community was so on top of their game as to immediately send relief funds. What do we do with all these damaged buildings? Are they just going to be fixed over time? Oh my goodness. Okay, we need to start rebuilding. We've got $27,000 to work with now. That's going to set us back quite a ways. We have 39% approval rating. We just need to get to over 50%. Let's swap this around just a little bit. I think it was right here, and I should have selected a different crop first. I think we can do that right now. I believe this Lord Oakesworth, I do not have time. It looks like some pirates are coming to steal our treasures. Okay, they've learned of my vast riches. They'll burn down buildings. You have to stop them. Use your troops to defend your buildings. Okay, pause the game. There's way too much going on right now. I've got to pause. I want to change this crop before I forget. There we go. It is now going to be corn. Where are the pirates? Let's zoom out. Here is the group of pirates, an enemy squad, 8 pirates in total. Luckily, we have 2 guard towers. Now, the real question becomes, how do I use them to fight for me? Do I just have to wait till they get close enough? They're going to be targeting this plantation by the looks of things, so perhaps they will walk past our guard towers and encounter our troops. Oh, they're sneaking through the jungles. Gonna get some guerrilla warfare up in here. I'm so glad that I built these guard towers, or perhaps they only arrived because I built guard tower. I'm not sure. Which came first, the chicken or the egg? It doesn't matter. I'm going to assume that I made a great executive decision. Oh, you can see them. You can see them firing out with their weapons from the guard towers. Oh, they're shooting fire rockets at the guard tower. Oh my. Okay, let's take a look. We've got 8 elite infantry versus 8 pirates. The forces seem evenly matched. We're getting some reinforcements by the looks of things. These guys are coming out of the palace, I think. I don't know where they came from. Lots of troops fighting here. Is anyone dead yet? Let's take a look at the pirates. They're down to about 3,000 health. You know, these old time... Oh, I saw one guy die. Just bit the dust. These old-timey muskets are very slow-firing, inaccurate things. I want to see some battle formations. Why do they have, like, mortars? I can see them reloading the muskets. I do like seeing the individual animations. Seems like we have repelled the pirates, and my crew is retreating back to their guard tower or to the palace. Okay, let's start repairing. We're going to rebuild for 1800 right there. We're going to repair these houses. We want people to continue to live in them. We've got tons of money at the moment, so I'm sure that it will all be fine. Most things have been repaired at this stage. We want, of course, to keep as many citizens living here as possible. And we very much want to repair the guard towers and the church. I think that's pretty much everything. We've still got $11,000 to work with. I think we handled that situation very well. So we've got our plantation is up. We've repelled pirates. We've suffered an earthquake. And we're down to 31%, but we're going to work real hard to get that happiness back up. Hopefully rebuilding everyone's houses will go a long way in that regard. So let's make our manager, Mate Lannister, the Cersei lookalike. We're going to hire you because you are pretty good at increasing mining and oil effectiveness by 10. So I think that's a good idea. I don't know how to import people to be managers or if I just need to start educating my people. To that end, we can take a look at the happiness and see what is the lowest healthcare, which we, I believe, still cannot afford. But more entertainment is a very real possibility. So let's take a look. Tavern is the only thing that's really going to provide some entertainment. I don't think the gardens are going to help. That's just going to increase the beauty. I think I did make a garden or two around here. You might be able to see them if you look closely enough. But let's make another tavern by some of the other houses back out this way. Let's make one right next to the dock. I think that's a good idea, and I don't know which way. I think this is the front, like rotating it every which way. All right, that's a good spot, and that should service the four houses right here and perhaps even the mansion, and these guys are going to have a choice as to where to go. I think we're going to go to the luxury entertainment tab, which I've only just discovered, and we're going to make an opera house. So I don't know how opera houses functioned in the colonial era, but I'm not going to argue with it. So it provides entertainment for richer citizens and tourists. Attach it to this road. Okay, so the front of it is going to be facing away from the plantation. It's going to cover up this shack so they don't have to look at it. Since we have an opera house going up, I figured why not extend the rich population here? So I've added another mansion across the street from this mansion. I've kind of ruined their view, haven't I? The property value is going to go down here because they can't see the beach anymore. I've like covered it up. Opera house is being built. The new tavern is here. And we've got some workers already employed. Now, we've got a couple of objectives. We want to make a new dock, apparently, and that's going to give us some revolutionary support. So let's see if we can do that for our people. The question is where to put it. What do we just say? Second. I guess that's not bad. I mean, the second dock can fit in right there. Let's make it two spaces over. And then we'll get a road going along next to it. All right. That's fine. That'll work perfectly, just like this one. And I think we're good to go. So can I... Oh, I need to cancel again. Okay, play the game. Let's watch as the opera house pops in here and admire its beauty with the palm trees out front and this wonderful paved tile. These pink and white flowers commissioned directly by the Lannister family. Ooh, I like that sound effect. That's awesome. Okay, so we need three people here. With a college education, we might need to invite some foreign workers paying a little bit of extra money. Looks like that underwater palace that His Majesty required is now underway, and he needs a bunch of crops to pay for it. He's demanded 10,000 of your cash crops. Revolutionaries find this number too high. Yeah, I would have to agree and suggest that you only send half that amount. Opposing this, the royalists demand that you send a Wait, what? So I would only really pick original amount if I really needed that 6 months. So I get 12 months if I sent double. We're going to send half for that increased revolutionary support. We're trying to get this thumbs up as high as possible so that we can rebel. That's all we really want out of life. Oh, and yeah, we have two workers here. That is impressive. I'm glad that we have some college-educated people that just happen to be living here. So I don't need to hire anyone else to work there just yet. That would probably be a waste of money. However, we are in the negative at the moment since we're exporting our cash crops. The revolutionaries determined that I was doing well, sent me three educated revolutionaries to help my cause, and I want to go ahead and explore now, even though we don't have a whole lot of money, so I'm selecting my base, and I'm just going to click on the explore for 1,000, and we're just going to go kind of back in this direction, I think. So we're sending the troops out. We should be able to see them exiting the palace. Here's my exploratory crew. And they're just going to kind of head out to that beacon, which I set for them. And should reveal this mine back here, a place for a mine. A deposit, as it were. And we're going to get a 6-month extension. We're really close now, guys. With the extra citizens we've been getting and the revolutionary support we've been accruing, we're at 48% approval rating. Feeling good about that. In the meantime, we're about to finish exporting those 5,000 crops to the crown, just to appease them. That's all we are trying to do. A lot of people have jobs, but let's take a look at the almanac and see how everyone is doing. The people. There's 13 unemployed, which means we could use another job or two. I want to make some mines out here, but they're just too far away. See, too far from road network connected to a construction office. So let's build a road way out here and see if that helps us at all. All right, so there's the road increase, and I believe back over here we got the mine. It's just, okay, it is close enough now. So that's good. All we have to do is extend the road a little bit. Oh no, construction on the underwater palace has been stopped. From now on, you will receive fewer, if any, options to extend your mandate. But His Majesty will grant you one of these rewards for your service. All right, so we're not going to get as many mandate extensions, so why not just take the mandate? That just seems the most practical to me. So we're getting the iron deposit going in here, and I'm curious what... Stop closing my windows! Oh dear. Should we send someone to meet with the Pirate King? Who will it be? Okay, so if we send Lord Oaksworth, we get increased revolutionary support. What if they, like, kill one of these guys? I don't think trade routes with the pirates is nearly as important as just winning this mission. Perhaps in Sandbox? Maybe I'll play Sandbox here pretty soon after this... Maybe after this mission. Who knows? Let's do increased revolutionary support for now. And I do want to check on the almanac support on the politics page. We're in good standing with 74. There's 44 supporters. And we're warm relations with the crown, but the royalists, they hate us. Let's do a little building observation here. We can see all the cattle just kind of wandering around and got some hay bales. These cattle not really utilizing the full space of their pen here, but that's okay. Got quite a few of them. Let's see what kind of... Oh, wait for it. Okay, we're looking at cows, a little busy here. We can proclaim independence. The island is ripe. Okay, I like this. Now, how do I do it? I love how the crown just sent me 6,300. Thanks for the money, guys, but I'm out of here. Okay, here it is. You ready? Your approval rating is high enough. Let us get away from their stupid demands. Proclaim independence. According to Lord Oaksworth, he's not very interested in us. The king, he doesn't really care. If we pay the empire for the losses, you'll be allowed to be independent. Otherwise, the royal forces will come for a visit. I don't want to be 10,000 in debt. I kind of want to be that guy who's just going to challenge them to a duel. Can I take a minute here to think about that? I got two guard towers. Let them come. All right, pause the game. Well, I didn't realize that the troops were already here, two squads of them. Will we be successful in fending them off? I don't know. They arrived really quickly. I don't know how they got our message and sent troops that fast. Maybe the troops were already waiting in ships offshore, just in case. I've queued up another guard tower and a second right next to the opera house. So that they're not going to have enough time to build. But you know what I can do? I can pay for a quick construction. Let's quick build for 2,200. All right. So we paid a whole lot extra, but look how fast this thing is being constructed all of a sudden. I just wanted to test out that option to see how well it worked. We'll let the other one just kind of go by itself. I don't want to waste that much money. Please, guys. Oh no, what's happening? Apparently, we've only just now finished researching the Constitution. Okay, so we've already got independence, or we're working on that. We're fighting for our independence. This is a true-to-form revolution right now. They are targeting our guard towers. Please let this building be finished, guys. Come on. I need you guys to complete the construction while they are here fighting. The guns have... Oh, there's more than two! There's three forces right now. Okay, well, we're under fire. We've got new citizens arriving in the middle of this conflict. It's 99% constructed. Why can't these guys just finish the job? Apparently, I've unlocked the achievement for Everlasting Colony. We've got The guard tower here is taking some heavy fire from three squads, it looks like. No, one squad is wrapped up on the front lines of the palace right now. Returning fire are elite troops. We've already lost one troop, so have they. Oh no, we just lost a tower! They sunk our battleship. There's still three squads we're about to lose. Oh, what have I done? I've bitten off more than I can chew. Oh, we'll rebuild it. We'll fight them again from the streets. And we'll quick build all of them. I don't think that our construction workers are going to complete these for some reason. Apparently we're just not allowed to in the middle of combat. I should have thought this through. We're about to lose our independence, guys. How come in this whole palace, we only had one group of troops? No. No, who is this? Oh, she's gonna die. They're gonna assassinate Mate Lannister. Well, I'm glad you could see me lose. That was fun. All this work, there it goes. I had to stick around to see it and see what happens. Oh, you literally quit to the main menu. Okay, great. Okay, so before you click off this video because you just watched Alex lose Tropico, he lost mission one. Can you believe that? I want to let you know what I'm going to do. I'm going to play a new game, and we're going to play Sandbox, okay? I've seen a lot of you ask for some Sandbox instead of the campaign, so that's what I'm going to do. If you guys like this idea, let me know by leaving your thoughts below and, of course, liking the videos that you enjoy. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Italics, and I'll see you next time with some brand new Sandbox Tropico 5.